Hello, 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 and welcome to ETFTL Season 25. This is the pre-season playoffs between Animate and Stevie Wonder's AIM School. My name is Bren, and I am joined today by the one and only, or her, yeah. Are you excited? Are you riveted to be here today,
I could not
casting
be
these
more
teams?
excited, Bren, for today's game between these two top-tier Premiership potential teams.
Well, I share your enthusiasm
That's it now.
because these teams, this is life or death. This is life or death. At the end of the day, loser goes home, goes back to high, in the very depths of high.
I actually die.
They actually get sacrificed to Sonny Black to help pay for the ETF2L fees, but we won't go into it. We do have a connect, so we will be getting into the game fairly shortly. I don't know what to expect from this game, to be honest.
I expect only the highest quality of TF2.
Yeah.
So I can imagine that we're going to be spoilt with all the plays that could possibly happen today. We've
I
got
see.
some of the toppest talent in EU, such as Phoenix.
Phoenix is playing. Oh, I see.
Orton, some of the incredibly experienced and well-known TF2 talent.
Yep.
Some people have said that these two are just some terrible haberdashery set of EU pug champ teams, but I say nay to that.
Say nay. Okay.
I say nay. We have got some hot talent here.
Hot indeed. No disrespect intended for me saying Phoenix is in the team. I was just surprised because Phoenix used to be in my team and I'm fucking terrible. So that's where the surprise is coming from.
Well, it's not really that much of a surprise then, because he is also terrible.
Okay, now you're firing some shots at,
My shots
players.
are best
People
fired when
don't appreciate this.
when people I'm firing the shots at can't retaliate. That's where I like to do them, from a safe distance in the comfort of my own home.
Right. Okay. Away from LAN settings where people can actually beat you up.
I did do it, Alan. I just did it very quietly.
Behind their backs.
Yeah. I apologize to them after. I'm sorry, buddy.
Sorry.
I didn't mean to. I was just making a meme for the Twitch chat. You are good. Your fans aren't 12.
Is this where's this coming from?
Because I did mention about how his fans were 12.
Yeah, did Banny confront you afterwards saying,
No,
"Hey man, what the hell are you
I
doing?" You know.
quickly ran away from the venue.
As fast as possible.
Yeah, after I said that, I hid in my hotel.
Oh, well, thankfully you're in your safe space now where you
Yeah.
can shit talk people to your heart's content.
Yeah, I can. I'm very excited. I played one of these teams yesterday. Can't remember which one it was. I think it was the Stevie Wonder one.
Yeah.
We beat them.
All right. How was it convincingly?
The first map was convincingly. The second map, not so much, but who cares? I'm in Prem. Suck it.
What was this down to then? What were the flaws? Really gonna dig deep here.
They are just a bunch of DM donkeys, it seems.
Right.
They just seem to jump in all the time, constantly trying to get frags. And that's it. After they don't get the frags, you just kill them and win. Having said that, I mean, we did only win Gullywash 5-4, but I like to think that it was because of this amazing qualifier system, which was presented to us by Sonny Black himself. We thought it was a good idea to make six teams play for five prem spots.
All right, you're throwing a lot of fire to Mr. Sunny Black, you know.
This is literally my therapy, where I can get everything off my chest.
He's not really given much of an opportunity to defend himself, so we won't keep digging into the ETF2R system. I'm very grateful that we even have a league in the first place, but you know, can't have it all. Can't have it all.
Interestingly enough, one of them, one of the two teams seem to have a mercenary in Zen. Well, unless they're actually on the roster.
Hmm.
Yeah, no, it's a merc, so this is going to be tasty. Zen's a very, very good player. He's going to be a difference maker. I wonder, wait, who is it? It is... Okay, so Zen's playing for Animate.
Right. Okay, this mm-hmm. could be changing things up a little bit.
Yeah. And we also have... One thing I wanted to mention is Fragmented. He's probably the most experienced player on the server. Maybe even in TF2 these days. I think his first season was Season 4.
Season 4?
You weren't even born there.
He's a dinosaur. I wasn't even born then.
You weren't even born. That would have been, like, scary. That's like...
mad to think about, isn't
it? Yeah. Like, I'm pretty sure 90% of the people as well in our chat weren't even born then. That was like in,
season
what?
Four.
I think that was 1856. That's when the season started of ETF12. So that's quite a while away. So it's, quite a long time away. And he's still playing now, trying to get into Prem for, I think, the very first time.
Well, now that all the players have actually left... Maybe now his opportunity. Huh? This could be
his
time
to shine.
That's
the same for pretty much everybody that's playing TF2 these days. I mean, just look at one of the teams that got in yesterday. What was it? 3 out of 6, they're called.
3 out of 6 was the first team I ever casted in high. And one of their players, Crayon, I remember this distinctly because for my first ever TF2 cast, I was really nervous. And I wrote loads of notes on both the teams. Thinking it was a proper serious thing. And then I realised nobody actually cares in TF2 casts. And you can just get away with just literally chatting inane nonsense. And people find it really funny. So from that point on, I just haven't really improved as a caster. So
yeah, I was just going to say, there's like no difference from that and now then.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So yeah, fun little tidbit. Crayon, like, I think he's just like been going up and up and up since just by basically only playing Medic. And now he's in Prem.
Well, they do say that Medic is the easy road to the high divs. That was once said by... Oh, God, it was Rare Spy Crab. 2011. Yep. No, it wasn't. It was Rare Spy Crab, David.
Stop addressing David.
No, I'm addressing him. I've done it. I'm pretty sure it was. Yeah, it is. It was Rare Spy Crab. He was an Irish guy. And that's the message that he left. He hasn't been online for about 5 years. Needless to say, he thought Medic was the easy road to the high divs.
Yeah.
Not so much for him.
Right. Yeah. Okay, let's talk about some of these players. T-Mac, Alfie, Settler, Ryder, Fragmented... And Zen's going to be the last player, isn't he?
They've got a very tasty lineup. I'm not quite sure as to why they lost to 3 out of 6 yesterday. That's quite a big upset. Because T-Mac, the Overwatch reject. So we've got two Overwatch rejects tonight. We've got T-Mac and you, Bren.
I haven't been rejected. I'm in the back pocket of Blizzard.
Is it sort of going... as well as your TF2 career went?
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, Blizzard are hiring me. I'm the inside man to kill TF2 off.
Oh, I see.
Like, Valve aren't doing it quick enough for their liking, so I'm here to just
speed
up the process. Well,
everybody knows that Sideshow's plan herring. Is to make a big TF2 LAN, but it's just going to end up into, like, we're all just going to go to, like, some weird shack in India, and no one's going to be there. Apart from Sideshow, as he takes a helicopter away with like Overwatch branding on the side.
Are they all leaving the server?
Because Phoenix, being the man from Israel, is not happy with the ping that he gets from Israel to a European server. And he has demanded that they change. I don't know if that is true, but I'm stirring the pot. So yeah, that's the reason why I'm sure it is.
Meanwhile,
who else are the other players? Settler's a good demo man.
Settler, yeah.
Known for quite bizarre demo man play. Probably
What's
one
your
of
opinion
the...
of it?
He's unpredictable, but in some ways predictable. Like, you're not sure what he's going to do.
But you know he's just going to be in
you know he's going to do something
with a weird sticky trap.
Yeah, you know he's going to do something stupid. And... it both like reassures you and makes you afraid, because you're not quite sure whether or not you're going to succumb to his devilish Finnish flamboyant trap. But yeah, there's also Ryder's Icelandic, so obviously some of the other Icelandic players can't play TF2 tonight as he's playing. He's a pretty good gamer as well, to be honest. I think I remember him playing Scout, but he's moved on to Soldier. And Leo, he's another guy that was pretty decent. So they've got people that are good at the game.
Yeah.
They do have good gamers. It's just that I don't know if they've got the coordination.
Isn't that the case of a lot of gamers these days?
It is, but maybe that's why they've got fragmented. Although, to be honest, maybe his, you know, Div 5 experience hasn't really sort of made its way into Prem yet. I don't think we've hit that much of a low level, but who knows? I think they've got, 11 on the server now. They're just waiting for Zen.
Waiting for a man.
Other team, they've got Yak. Yak was there to oversee a dodgy deal that I did at LAN, as someone slyly passed me a Logitech G Pro before it was released. He was there to use his very, very large coat to block the transaction from any prying eyes. Alfie, obviously one of the players from the original Danger Dogs that I have now infiltrated and made my own. Martin, I don't know. Melo, I have no idea. Phoenix plays Pickup 2, and so does... No, plays Pugmy, and so does Leto.
Here's a fun fact for you, War.
Hit me.
Phoenix, actually... speaks I don't know what language they speak in Israel. Probably Israeli. Hebrew. But he also speaks Russian.
Ooh, that's a very, very exotic combination of languages.
Wow. It is weird. And it was actually Phoenix was gonna be considered. He does speak English, so he's a trilingual person.
That's like me being able to speak English as well as like Swahili.
Exactly. Why not?
Or Klingon. You know, that's a very, very sort of strange set of languages that you learn.
I don't think that's a thing, is it? Do people actually really speak Klingon?
Yeah, they do. They learn Klingon. They speak. Have you not seen the documentary Trekkies?
No,
you should watch Trekkies. It's about Star Trek fans, and people do proper speak Klingon to each other. And they are, by God, some of the most beautiful people I've ever seen.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
They all look like Greek Adonises.
But yeah, he was up for consideration when the Bagsa 5, when they were just falling to pieces, he was up for consideration because he spoke Russian. But the countdown's begun. Enough about the players. Nobody cares about them. We're just here to watch fat air shots, and it's going to be Badlands as the first map between Animate and Stevie Wonder's AIM squad. We're going to see what gamers look to surprise us today, if any at all. But ultimately, I'm expecting big things from a few of these members. We see the mid fight kicking off already. A lot of spam being exchanged, but really nobody taking the damage. Nobody wants to take the initiative. The train's finally going to get taken up by the Stevie Wonder squad. Alfie from behind finds Fragmented. That's going to be the medic down straight away. Mayo with the follow-up onto Ryder. This looks like peanut duty. Both scouts are the only ones remaining for Animate. And Zenith is mincemeat, I believe. Unless he can get a kill. There's a possibility for it, but... No, he's not going to get out.
He's out. He's out.
Okay, he steals the frag, and he steals the show. Just like that, and he just escapes into the mist.
And Alfie has said in chat that he has dropped his bag of Doritos. Hopefully he recollects them and... gets them back in the bag before the 5 second has elapsed. Interestingly, T-Mac is actually playing Soldier, so that is a pretty tasty upgrade for them, to be honest, going from his Orsomniac days, etc, etc, as he recycled through many, many French teams.
Well, Equilubers, the Stevie Wonder guys, it looked like they want to try and take it through to a resupply area. They were committing a few men. They're ultimately not going to be getting anything from it. So, we wait patiently for the opening move to be made. It's like a game of chess between two Year 7 students.
That's giving them a lot of credit. Yeah, some year 7 students are probably amazing at chess.
That's true, yeah. Was there a chess club at your primary school?
Probably, but if there was, I wasn't told about it, because they probably didn't want me to be in it. They're looking like they're going to go through house, though. Oh, no, they're going for a resup push. I like these.
Resupply. Here we are. Moving in. Making them move. We see Ryder. He's in the resupply area. Might be able to catch someone off guard, but it's actually Settler who finds the first kill. Uber's actually popped as well. Only getting one frag for it. Settler falling to the scattergun of me. So, that was a balcony.
Settler did one of his trademark plays and was actually able to get a force of it, as well as the soldier pickle letter as well. Alfie's now trying to sort of take a few jousts in lower lobby, but loses because he can't win a 3v1. He's not MG Michael Adams.
Not quite. But now this is 100% Uber. They're going to pop it early off, see if they can lead it in. T-Mac wants to take the charge. A few rockets in, is going to spam them pretty far back. Currently, I think they're only going to be able to get this midpoint from it. No frags going their way. A lot of spam from Yak. Might just connect onto someone. In fact, May might be the first one to fall. Indeed, Alfie's going to find Ryder. T-Mac finds May, so they're only trading one for one right now. Orton is in the back lines, causing a bit of distraction on the Grey Bridge, but it's Martin who says, "You've got no way, lads. I'll get the job done."
And that was upsetting still to see. Orton was doing a really good job distracting them, but then nobody
they didn't play
went
off
in.
Them.
Yeah, that was quite... That was baity. How dare they?
A bit odd, but as we stand, we see them recapping up the mid now. Stevie Wonder's AIM school. Having a jolly old time, just really communicating together nicely. And is this coming in with the Uber charge? Yak moves in, gets the drop onto Fragmented. The follow up, the point by Settlet. Unreal stuff by this prodigy of the man who, frankly, I don't think people were really going to be expecting much, but he's turned up to prove the haters wrong. Orton is going to be trying to get that back cap on. He's going to get stopped by Phoenix, but takes the fight anyway. Zenith with him is going to find that kill, but it's too little too late as the spire area is already taken up now. Alfie and Yak on the move, along with Martin. So that's three men. They looked like they wanted to carry it forward, but I think they realised they would have got sandwiched if they took it any forward. Nice rockets by Alfie. Connects one onto Zenith. Not going to get the second one. You might be able to hear that car in the background revving around, but right now, I think they're going to have to back off this second point. Indeed, they are playing it quite passive, just waiting for the entry and waiting for mistakes to be made. And there we go. There's Settler picking up one kill onto Yak. So with no down around wall, we may see it push.
Yep, and Settler does go down as is tradition, where he gets a pick and then dies himself. So ultimately, he's done nothing for his team apart from giving them a bit of a disadvantage because he do need the down around to defend.
Well, they're going to be moving in with the Uber straight away. Stevie Wonder's AIM school tries to get the frags, but they end up dropping so many players because of it. Martin just cannot keep his men healthy. And as a result, it looks like Animate are going to be able to take initiative. Leto is on the back lines, though. He is going to get taken down, however, before he can get any more kills. So they seem a bit hesitant to push out, but now with these picks, you'd be mad not to.
This is already becoming one of those games which I'm sure I'm going to remember, not because of the quality of the tier 2, but for how many stupid mistakes are being made. We saw Fragmented drop to, well,
he's gonna die.
One sticky.
Oh my goodness.
Oof.
Alfie literally was just spamming him from behind. They get the force out. Animate now look to take this forward. See if they can get anything at all. Ryder leaps into the fray, but Yak sticky trap is there to bring him down. So right now, Animate, they got a lot on their plate. They got a bit to work off here. I mean, it is one frag going either way, but Ryder's not up for another 10 seconds, but did a Stevie Wonder's AIM school squad even want to play off this? It looks like they do. They're moving through the resupply area and they're giving up a lot of room.
Oh, Settler is probably going to... Oh, he does get out with a sliver of HP.
That's a classic, that one. Well played.
Thanks.
But I don't know which way this fight's going. It's very scrappy. Settler's trying to get kills in the trash area. Phoenix takes a 1v1 against Zenith, does win it. Uber's now going to be popped off by the Stevie Wonder's AIM squad, and we're going to see if they can get anything from it. Fragmented just trying to escape. Maybe delving a little bit too deep there. Is he gotten out? He's got a health back, and he is going to get out, so...
Yeah, this is very, very, very scrappy, as you're saying. I mean, that fight on Spire was incredibly awkward. Because they went through resup, they managed to block the path of three players, so those were just three easy frags, but they took their sweet time of even, like, getting onto them. And Settler, despite his awful positioning, was able to get out uncontested, but now they've got an Uber disadvantage. So now...
It's a bit weird.
Valve, fix that, please. That's pixel walking.
What the heck? Here we go. Uber's coming in by Animate, looking to see if they can create some room, create some pressure, maybe create a few kills. And May on the back lines is going to be trying to take this 1v2 right now against Ryder. The backup of Orton is going to be able to bring him down. Setlup follows up with a kill onto Alfie. Uber's charge still in the hands of the Stevie Wonder's AIM school, so they could still get some work done. Orton finds Leto. These are three kills now. Alfie's only just about to respawn. They realize they have to back off. They can't take this, even though they do have the Uber advantage. And Animate going to be happy with it. And still nil-nil.
That was a good push out, to be honest. Most teams would be very reluctant, i.e. Crowns, to push out from that. But they braved it, despite it being 0-0. And now they're going to be faced with a full Uber disadvantage, which has now been popped.
Yeah, the Uber got popped off there by the Stevie Wonder's AIM school. They didn't get anything from it because it was very well kited by the Animate guys. Now we're going to see if anything can actually play. Zenith is behind. I don't think they realize this. Oh, he's got the drop onto Martin. Two shots is all it takes. Even when he was under the pressure, the entirety of the team turned around. He finds the kill anyway. So fragmented. Going to be happy with that 100% Uber advantage that he has been gifted. But the question is, pushing out of last can be tricky, especially for some of these lesser coordinated teams.
They're going to attempt it anyway. To tally the amount of mistakes that have happened this game.
Where are you right now?
No, I was just trying to reach for a pen, which I've now received, so I could tally said mistakes, because Martin being left alone on launchpad with nobody behind looking, that is a schoolboy error and a half.
It's very odd. I don't quite understand what's happening. There's two members of the Stevie's school currently behind, Phoenix included. I don't think T-Mac even realises, in fact. He's looking around trying to find him. Now Phoenix could try and get the cap.
Oh, jump
on the fragmented. Can he take the kill? Oh, not quite. T-Mac, two on top of it there. Finds the rocket, finds the kill. Now we're going to see them move forward, seeing if they can take their initiative. There's a lot of kills that have gone their way, but right now they're trying to make their move. May finds the first one to T-Mac. That's not a player you want to lose. It's a very, very crucial role indeed. And now Stevie's school can look to push forward, to try and punish off this overextension, potentially. I think Animate realise they're in a bit of a sticky situation. They're going to be backing off from this as the Stevie school look to push forward, but right now they're going to be meeting head on. My finds one. Can I get any more though? That is the question. The damage, not quite there. Ryder did find a kill in the midst of all this chaos, but Ryder's leaping in again. This is a very drawn out fight. In fact, the Uber's going to be exchanged by both these teams now as they look to try and take it as far as they possibly can. Zenith very weak, having to try and back off. Phoenix going to be trying to get hot on his tail. Ryder finds Alfie. Zenith finally does actually take the 1v1 against Phoenix, who was on full health and wins it on half health. Really impressive stuff going off over there. And Fragmented did fall in the midst of it. So once again, Martin is going to have this Uber advantage, providing he gets out alive.
Like, the amount of misplays is making me puke. Like, how you could be like on 30 HP and lose against... how you can lose a fight against a scout that isn't 30 HP is beyond me. That is... You literally just have to... You don't even have to do a full, you know, precise hit. You can even like just do with missing a bit and you could still kill him. That was... Oh my god, I don't know.
You're puking everywhere, are you?
That's upsetting.
Just having sicky parties all over the place. But
it's just...
Leto moving into the fray now. He leaps forward. The Uber's charge is going to get popped off as well. He's waiting for that flash. He's falling incredibly weak. And in fact, Animate knew exactly what to do. They played them like a bloody fiddle. And they backed all the way off. The back cap is currently in effect by Ryder, but... And here we go to distraction plays as well, but they're just getting cleaned up so much. Orton now should be an easy kill. Indeed he is, as Alfie is there to save his team from embarrassment. Now they're looking to move even further forward. Ryder is still behind, remember.
Why are they still in?
Ryder could get a kill here. He's right onto the back of Martin. Two rockets, mine so weak. He's got the kill. He's got another one, surely. Oh my goodness. Martin just about survives. Phoenix takes him down.
Why was Fragmented even in, though? It was just two of them.
Who knows? Who knows?
Like 90% Uber, and they go, yeah, we can definitely hold choke against five. Let's do it, team.
Woohoo! Alright. Okay. Now we're going to see Zen is hiding behind enemy lines. He picks up one. He picks up Yak. Can I get any more? He's wiggling his way out of the resupply area. In fact, there's two scouts there. Is he really going to try and take this fight? There's three men now waiting for him. Surely not. He's so cocky. He's so confident. Just an ideal man, really, isn't he?
He also has a moving spray. which I haven't seen since like 2008.
Well, Uber's going to be popped in now by the Stevie Wonder's AIM school, and they're not going to be getting anything from it because of Zen on Pyro. Brilliant plays by that man. The leap into the fray by Leto tries to bring down Fragmented, trying to make that Uber advantage a little bit less, right down to zero, in fact, but unfortunately couldn't get the rocket. So we see Alfie taking up that little pixel walking position again. He's backed off. He realizes Animate, they want to try and contest this. In fact, they've got a lot of cap time right now. They could try and make some plays.
Fragmented has fallen,
though. Yak and May finding these kills.
Phoenix.
Settler finds Phoenix. T-Mac finds Leto. And there's the Uber going to be popped off now as well. Yak surely not going to get out of this. He's leaped away, but he's so weak. One chip shot with the scattergun will do it, but the arrow by Martin is enough to keep him healthy. So he's not going to be paying with his life just yet. But those two casualties, those two frags, going away of Animate, the respawns are already up, so they're not going to be able to capitalize off it. But
Fragmented was standing still and he missed his shots. Oh, what is this game?
This is Premiership War. This is Prem.
Oh, no, it's not. Not yet.
Maybe not. Maybe not. Who knows? Who knows? But we're going to see them moving in. Now, once again, it's still nil-nil, a back-and-forth tug-and-war. Leto getting a few decent rockets in. In fact, Alton is behind him right now. Ryder leaps in, getting onto the back of Martin. Misses one rocket, and he's finally got the force just from his sheer presence. Didn't even fire off a rocket. And now, the response is there. The back cap by Alton as well. This could be absolutely critical for them. Settler finds the pipes! Absolutely incredible. Fragmented finds Yak as well. Settler going absolutely huge. Martin now tries to take the 1v1. Not going to be happening. And this is looking so good for Animate right now. Orton already on the second point, capping it up. This is looking good.
That is diabolical. I mean, I know like I know that when you're sort of getting back capped, you want to commit forward, but you're in no position. As soon as you see like the enemy team attempting to block, that is your cue to back out, because win that fight, you know? Yeah. It's going to be almost impossible unless everybody hits air shots. And unfortunately, they were the ones that got air shotted by Settler.
Mm-hmm. Well. It's going to be an Uber advantage on the side of Animate as they look to take the charge all the way in. Orton wants to lead it in. Can they bring down Mado? May's doing a brilliant job of deflecting it for now, but now the Uber charge is about to fade, and now they're going to be forcing these players to the low ground. It's a little bit too late, as it is going to end up 1-0 in the end. Animate instead, they kited them. They did the correct thing, but they just weren't there to really repair the damage done.
Settler did very well. We pretty much won them and helped secure that round there. And the back counts by the scout is like, do these teams know about flanks?
No.
And the other routes of Badlands that isn't free spa.
Mid fight number two is about to kick off of CP Badlands map number one. We're going to see which way it actually goes. Ryder leaps into the fray, trying to get one kill. Phoenix brings him down, maybe to follow up onto Zen. Settler finds Leto, however. He's a lot of kills going away. Settler does fall. Orton now might be the next casualty as Phoenix is hot on his tail. Is he going to get it? No, he's not going to get a kill. He's going to back off straight away. So there's a bit of a scrappy mid-fight. Both medics did survive, however. And they could look to recontest if they so wish, but it looks like they aren't going to maybe go for it. It's a pause. This is a pause we are viewing.
That means that something critical has happened, which has instigated the pause, or they've, you know, entered a stalemate situation where they can now pause, or someone's won a round.
I haven't seen any of these unlocks come out yet. Whitelist has been opened up, guys, you know. Be a bit more creative.
Yeah, there is
play the Cal Mangler.
Yeah, exactly. That was one of the many unlocks that I ran that secured us many victories. I'm just checking through their inventories now to check to see if anybody is running something. And no. That's upsetting.
Oh, here we go. Unpause. Oh, repause. Alright. 100% Uber. Still on both these team sides. So, or is it actually? No, it is. It is. It's going to be 100% Uber. Collect your thoughts in a concisive sentence. Never mind, there's an unpause.
Garbage.
Don't collect your thoughts. I thought you were going to say that. I don't know why.
Well, I thought you were going to say one word and not a sentence, so I went with garbage for both answers.
Alright, okay. Stevie Wonder's AIM squad looking to make their mark on the world of Premiership ETF2L. As they are currently one round down, moving their way in, Zen has found Yak. No Demoman now for the Stevie squad. But is that enough to really play off right now? They look like they want to try and go for maybe a second one. Moving through this house area as it stands. Seeing if they can get any magic done. They're being very, very slow to play to it. Here we go, finally moving in with the Uber charge all the way on. Martin finally going to be popping off his as well. So it's going to be an equal Uber exchange so far. Ryder jumping into the back lines. This pulled three members of the Stevie squad back. Unfortunately, no one is there for the Animate to play off. They are only four players up, remember. Settler finds one kill. He's going to be leaping back as well. Nice little sticky jump by him.
He's still in very deep, though.
Zen's found Alfie, though. He's so deep, but his team is there to play off it. T-Mac finds a rocket onto Phoenix. It's going to get absolutely slaughtered in the end. And Martin finds Settler with the arrow as well. So, right now, two players down. Equal Uber, it should still be said. So, they can't exactly just plow straight into them with the Uber charge. But it's a sticky situation as it stands.
Yeah, but he always goes incredibly deep, Settler. It's kind of worrying. He goes in deeper than my dad goes into my mum.
Yeah. Okay. Why not?
That's a lie, they're divorced.
I shouldn't laugh. I don't know if you're being serious or not. I really shouldn't laugh. But Uber's going to be popped off now by the Stevie squad. See if they can pop their way in. Zen finds Leto with the pyro. He finds a second one as well with the damage done. T-Mac to clean up. Two kills going their way. And ultimately, I don't know. I don't know, War. What are we watching?
It's very strange because Stevie Wonder's aim school seem to be in a very, very advantageous position all the time. But they just seem to mess up the final push as we see.
A pause. Yep.
Well timed. Yep. Thanks, guys. It's because I actually typed to them, can you please pause soon? Because I need to, you know, summarize this terrible state of TF2.
But, yeah, go on.
It just seems like they're just not able to work up. It seems like on Spire, because obviously there's so many ways for people to get around them, they as I was saying before, they have no flank. They have no real sort of sturdiness. What they need is they need a man. They need a man called Drac. Drac who would watch a door, you know, no matter what.
Yeah.
You watch it. And that's what they're lacking. They're lacking some stability in the flank that will actually give them the confidence to move forward without having to, you know, play it slow or worry about back caps. And it just seems to be they're not on the same wavelength.
Definitely the impression I've got. I just couldn't really formulate it into words because I lack the vocabulary and the brain.
I do as well, but I just use the most incorrect words. I just hope that it's in the right context. I don't actually know what the meaning is of them. And my grammar, my amazing grammar, I'm sure makes up for it as well.
It's hard. It's hard for us guys, isn't it? Really.
I speak idiots. English, but I can't learn England.
Right. TF2 as a game
is still alive and well, as we can see with some of our amazing TF2 that is being played. It doesn't look like anybody's going to be able to block this Spire at all because Yak's not in a position, so they're going to get Spire. Oh, my profit.
There we go. Yeah. So they got the cap. Yak did find Zen, so that is one kill going away. I'm not sure how many players are actually up. In fact, Spire is going to start to get capped up. They're trying to contest the lobby at the exact same time, which is the smartest move to make. They have regained a bit of ground from Animate, but question is, can they capitalize off it? They don't have the Uber advantage. It is equal Uber. But there is the possibility for some off-classing, some maybe gimmicks is the word I would use, to see if one team can get ahead.
Just to wait, this Natasha heavy.
It's Natasha unbanned, isn't it?
Thanks, Mr. Slynn.
They're going to be popping in with the Uber charge now. Moving in, Stevie's squad tries to take the lead with Leto leading the charge of the Uber charge. Ryder finds May somewhere in the midst of all this, and now Leto looks like he's going to be the next casualty. Or not. Oh, yeah, he is. Ryder finds him. So, three kills going away as Martin falls as well to Orton. That's going to be no medic. In fact, they might get caught out of position. Or not. Yak finds Zen. T-Mac does find Alfie in the midst. No, they're definitely getting caught out of position here. They just started. What were they doing there, then?
I believe they were
May's in the back. Oof. Hold that thought for 1 second. He's going to be taking a 1v1 against Ryder now. Is he going to be able to win this? Not quite. Ryder's rockets a little bit too much on point there, and it's a difficult fight to take for the scout man. But ultimately, they can see which way they can potentially move this in. T-Mac now leaps forward, trying to get those rockets in. Alfie into the back. He's onto Fragmented. Can he get a rocket? Whee! Sender's pipe. Beautiful stuff. Finds him. Smack bang in the air. Saves his medic's life. Making up for maybe a few of the inadequacies. But ultimately, they are going to be moving forward off the back of this. That one pick is what they needed. In fact, they've got 100% Uber as well to work off. So, ideally, they're not going to be wanting to pop it off just yet. Phoenix finds Zen, so that's one frag to try and pave the way open for the Stevie squad. But Uber was also popped off, and they haven't really got much from it apart from really getting this ground. They are going to get the Spire here, but Martin is in a position to re-pop off of this Uber, providing he does survive. In fact, it looks like, yeah, I think Stevie's squad are in a very good position here. T-Mac ends up killing himself before taking Phoenix's life. It's very messy, TF2. I just don't know what's going on. And now Orton's on the back cap.
This is a result of the mass exodus of talent in TF2, or probably just correctly known as no flank gaming.
Right.
Because these teams are not. Well, I say these teams. Well, actually, yeah, I do say these teams. But Leto.
Okay.
That's unfortunate. When you miss four rockets, maybe you aren't meant to play in Prem.
But they're going to be moving off it anyway. Phoenix finds Settler. May finds Ryder. Uber Charge is going to get popped as Yak leads it in. Bit of an aggressive play by the young demo man, Prodigy. We're going to see if they can create any more room off of it. Orton forms very, very weak. He's at the back off. But this is going to be the midpoint capped up by the Stevie squad. And it's still a one round deficit. There are 9 minutes remaining on this server. I believe there's 9 minutes. I don't think the pause has messed that up. But my goodness. Nine minutes remaining, and they've... This is very... It's just odd. It's just odd TF2. Can't put my finger on it.
Well, I can, and you can hear me do it now.
Thank you for that.
Sorry.
Thank you. Anyway, May finds Ryder. One pick going away. The headshot as well, as Zen does find Alfie. So, Ubercharge was popped off there. Martin does have a hefty Ubercharge advantage. In fact, his team look like they want to play off it. And they are going to be playing off as they look to move in. T-Mac into the back lines a little bit too late. Couldn't exactly get the drop that he wanted. And Phoenix is going to be leading the charge forward. Finds Zen. Settler with the follow-up onto him. Can he take this 1v1 against Yak now? The pipes are coming out, but everything is missing. And now the team is there to follow it up. Ryder finds one kill. At the same time, in the back lines, there's two men on the red team. Trying to tango with two other members, Alfie and Leto, trying to fight them off. Orton has bought a lot of time for his team. In fact, Ryder's moving into the fray now. Hits off one rocket onto Martin. Not going to be able to get the second one off. They're just throwing bodies at them. And just...
It's just too scrappy. Like, I can't really sort of follow what's going on, because every time I see one of these incredibly strange plays, I just black out.
Yeah, yeah. The second point is going to get capped up here.
Yeah, Settler's going.
Settler's going for a... Okay. One of those signature Settler plays. He picks up Yak.
That's a TCM bite. I've actually heard he's got an armored Fanzer shrine at home.
Has that bought some time? Are they still going to play off this? In fact, they are. They're going to be moving in with the Uber. But look at that denial by Zen. Denies about 5 seconds off that Uber chance. Brilliant plays by him, and now they're going to look to try and play the point. Or are they? Settler's got the stickies on there. Lockdown. May finds Orton at the same time. 7 kill streak for that guy. Uber chance going to be coming out now by Fragment as they look to try and contest this for as much as they possibly can. Settler finds May with the pipe. Can he get a second one? Yes, he can. Leto going to be falling. Now Alfie tries to take the fight to him. Does bring him down, but T-Mac going to follow up. Now it's just T-Mac against the world. The spawners are coming up. Can he do it? Not going to be happening, as it is going to be one all in the end. Martin and Phoenix finally do it. Alfie got 4 kills that push. 4 frags going under his belt.
If I could count that high, I'd be impressed.
Unfortunately, you can't. So no. That's why you're stuck here casting with me. All right. Don't mean to put you down. I'm just trying to set a realistic, you know...
Well, I only learned how to read at LAN, as Commander X told me, so baby steps.
Here we are, mid-fight number 3, kicking off already. Ryder onto the back lines, has found Yak. It's going to be no Demoman. A lack of damage for them, maybe. Potentially, as Leto does find T-Mac as well. But these frags are going completely the way of Animate, as they are just mopping the floor with them. Martin may just about get out. If Phoenix gets out, he can latch onto him. Maybe that added speed will help him. Alton trying to take the fight to them. Now Settler and Fragmented moving into them. I don't think they're going to be able to get it. In fact, Settler, he leaps onto the Spire, getting ready to cap it up for his team. So, a well played, well executed mid-fight by Animate. I think they definitely worked off the back of Ryder's Soldier Bombs. But now, Stevie's Wonder Aim School is looking to try and contest this if they can. In fact, they have forced them off the Spire. Phoenix moving forward as well. Settler has found Alfie, however, so that might stave off this aggression that they're trying to put in here. In fact, the Uber's going to get popped off here by the Animate Squadron, and they're going to see if they can get any kills. In fact, they leap the wraparound. This is absolutely critical. I can't believe this. Alton falls. Everyone's falling. Ryder finds Martin, however. Was that a drop? I don't know. Okay. As I said, scrappy TF2. Nobody quite understands what's going on here.
And they still cap it.
And they still cap it up.
Okay. Amazing. Let's, here's a fun fact for you. We all like fun facts. Nope, wait. Never mind.
Are they going to get... They're not. Nope. No. Ryder's here. Ryder's there. Ryder's everywhere. They do finally get the Spire. Now Alfie's going to be leaping in, seeing if he can get the kill. T-Mac finds him. Perfectly placed rockets by him. Phoenix is going to be following suit as well. So they are losing a lot of players here, hemorrhaging them, in fact. Leto is going to fall. In fact, I say Leto is going to get a pick onto Orton. So, I mean, it's a very difficult game to try and work out what the heck is going on. Fragmented does have 100% Uber, however, so they are going to be able to work off that. But, I mean, I guess they're just going to wait for Orton to respawn.
I'd hope they'd be a little bit more aggressive, though, if you know, they do have an advantage. You kind of
really,
want to be...
They've given up a lot of space here.
I mean, now they're able to sort of set up a lobby, which is not what you want. You kind of would... Well, I would have thought they would have heard Yax put stickies on the main door and they would have climbed Spire, but... They're probably just not as good at the game as me.
Well, they're trying to wiggle their way in. As it stands, they've lost their humongous advantage. Martin does have 100% Uber now, so they can afford to defend this if they look to push in, which it looks like they are. They're moving in off the balcony area. But then again, in this game, anything could actually happen. They're going to be trying to take the fight head on now. Ryder finds one. Phoenix with a follow-up onto him. So it is a 1-for-1 trade in the end, and look at that. Passive positioning is immediately being held by the Stevie squad. Alfie might get caught out of position, though. He just about backs out, so... I mean,
That wasn't so bad. I was worried that Fragmented might pop when Ryder was low, but he didn't. Even though he dropped him, it was just good that he just didn't sort of like get an itchy mouse to finger button pressing thing and use it early, because everybody from Stevie Wonders were way away. So if he had popped there, that would have been quite bad. Ryder goes in for a force, is quite stopped in his tracks and just left to stand there, awkwardly staring at the medic that he tried to kill but failed.
Thinking emoji is what I'm thinking right now.
Oof, I'm thinking upside down smiley face. David, nobody cares what you think because they can't hear you.
Oh, David, just the ghost in our ears. It just whispers funny things, and sometimes I giggle and it looks weird on stream.
Don't lie, it doesn't say anything funny.
Don't bully the producer, please.
That's what I'm... I'm the talent.
I'm the talent. Right, where's my cream latte?
Please, I will go back to my trailer, and then you can speak to my agent.
Well, Ryder's going to go for attempt number two, or not, as he gets completely mashed into potato.
There is only 1 minute 50 seconds remaining.
Yeah, that's worth pointing out.
That's not... That's going to be good for Animate, because they can just literally go for a, you know, balls to the walls push, and if it goes wrong, it doesn't matter. So what I'd really like to see, they know where the heavy is. There's, you know, they could just do a double soldier spam bottom right.
They could. Yeah.
I mean, they could even go bottom right anyway, because they can see three players top left, so the right side is going to be relatively thin on firepower, especially as a heavy isn't so good at burst damage as much as a soldier is. But they go
be
for
moving in. Yeah, that's... Uber's going to be popped off. Martin's going to be popping his off as well. Equal Uber exchange. And not much getting off him. In fact, Alfie's coming out on top as he's holding down that flank area. Picks up Ryder in the end. But is this 1 minute enough time to play off? Settler finds May. At the same time, Zen are going to be going down. Now they're going to be starting to play the point, pushing a few of these players down. T-Mac doing a brilliant job so far. And now Leto and Martin on the floor. Oh my goodness, that stray rocket just finding him in the end. So it was a nice, cutesy little play. Unfortunately, didn't work out for them. And Ryder looks like he maybe wants to go for the Hail Mary. No, he's going to be backing off.
There's still 30 seconds remaining. That is more than enough time for him to cap it.
So you know, Ryder went to the toilet before.
This is it. They could literally just go for it now.
Well, this is it. Yeah, they have to go for it. I mean, there's only about 15 seconds left. T-Mac finds the entry that they could have needed. In fact, they're going to be starting to play the point off now. Zen gets a lot of cap time off. The hemorrhaging onto the point and the choke is real. We're not going to be going to a golden cap, ladies and gentlemen, because Animate are going to be taking the first map 2-1 in the end. That was a choke if I've ever seen it.
That is joke from I-58 here. I won't repeat it because there's obviously younger people watching now. But that was very messy. But to be honest, Zenith and Settler played quite consistently well. Settler did sort of really play a bit risky at quite a few occasions, getting himself into very questionable areas, but somehow surviving. So maybe it wasn't a questionable area at all, and I'm just a washed up demoman, which is probably the correct thing.
I don't think you're washed up. You know, thanks. Back in a day,
I did shower this morning.
Yeah, back in the day war when I had aspirations of playing Team Fortress 2 as a demo man, I used to watch your demos.
That's quite
sad. So you can take that from you, you know.
So that's, in that case, if you've been watching me play, I must be the reason why you're so bad at this game, and I do apologize. Yeah,
exactly, I didn't improve at all. So
yeah, I do. I'm very sorry. But anyway, six. The top fraggers, four out of six of them are part of the names Animate players.
Oh, we have logs. I forgot.
Yeah, we do. Ah, I've got it as my homepage, mate. It's
home refreshes in the house.
I've got an RSS feed.
Can I get a refresh of the log, please?
So I can see him ASAP.
I can't see it.
Ah! Oh, I don't have the who's play where thing.
I clicked on it. Can you refresh it? Can you reload the logs?
Don't
I can see it.
Acknowledge production. They're not here.
Don't acknowledge production. I can see it now. It's worth saying, men and women who are watching this stream.
Don't be dark.
You know, I'm real sick of you, Paul. Real sick and tired of you, alright? You come in here, disrespecting production, asking for cream latte coffees, you know.
That was you.
Oh, we all knew it was you.
I know, I asked for a Danish swirl at that, and I've never got
Danish
one.
Danish swirl.
Yeah.
Wait, what even is that?
We need to get a resident Danish here to let us know. I'm sure there's loads in chat. I see Beater in there, so you should know.
Yeah.
No. But, there were... Settler and Zenith played really well that game. Zenith especially had quite a few clutch moments. And I think overall, Orton has a really, really, really dog shit ratio, but he's got 21 assists.
Yeah, that's pretty big.
So, you know, maybe that's the sort of player that you want in your team. You know, someone that's not selfish, someone that gets somebody down to 1 HP and is like, you know what, mate, you take the frag. You finish
him
off.
Maybe we need more of these players.
We do.
These unselfish players.
Unfortunately, we're left with people like Phoenix. Anyway, he had a good ratio anyway. But the real stat is obviously that T-Mac got 11 air shots. That's a very good stat to have going forward, especially if you're going to be in Prem and you get those cool stats at the start of the games.
Not only that, it's that people value your worth as a soldier just purely on your frag movie. So if you get a lot of air shots, you know, maybe you slip a few keys to the right person, they create a frag movie for you. Suddenly, you're the best soldier in Prem. That's how it works.
11 potential frag movie clips there.
Yeah, exactly. Anyway, it's going to be Gully Wash. Given how slow-paced Badlands was, I really have no clue how this is going to end up.
It's slightly harder to do some of the... well, the flanks aren't as wide, so it's not as punishing. It's quite easy to get from point to point, so there isn't a large distance that needs to be travelled. It can still happen, though. And based on the slow reaction time of these teams, it could very well happen.
Well, looking at a few more of these logs, I mean, we're just shifting through them just to see if there's anything of value picking up. Relative frags by zone. Defense by the Animate guys, as you can see from that, in the positives, in their own side. So really then just showing the inability of Stevie Wonder's AIM squad to kind of push, I suppose, and take hold of the advantage they already have. They did win the mid-fights. They came on top with that, at least, but Zen had a big showing on the mids.
Yeah, I think the Spire to last, well, second and last pushes from Stevie Wonder's AIM school was very, very poor. Especially, I think they got back-capped about twice when trying to cap Spire, so it's just sort of lacking coordination. This map should be a little bit better for them because, as I was saying, the flanks aren't so, like, there isn't, like, a large distance between the points, so it should be easier and harder for players to get behind. Although there is, you know, lobby, which there's quite a few hiding spots, so if, I think they might fare a better chance. We played against them yesterday on this map. Yawning. Not because of the boredom of TF2, but because of the boredom of you, Bryn. But anyway.
Okay!
But anyway, they did quite well. But we were absolutely awful. So, I don't know. What I've just said is pretty much pointless.
Yeah, I don't care what you said now after saying that to me. Sorry. I don't care anything about you. What, I just you don't
were,
care.
You were spreading care this information about me demanding lattes at LAN.
Alright.
I just wanted a simple pastry. Alright.
Shut up, kid. Kid. How does it feel being called a kid?
I'm like seven? Old enough to be your dad.
I don't think you are, but
you started school for the first time last week.
Yep. I am 4 years of age.
So I meant primary school.
Can I get a different co-caster, please?
As if you can't really have guessed, the reason why I'm here is because nobody else was available.
Can I get a different co-caster, please?
Just get David to mute me. Do you have admin rights?
I do, yeah, I think. Hold on.
Hey, there you go, you can just...
No, wait. I don't.
Oh, okay. Which
can I
means...
drag you that? No, I can't drag you. Hello. we both got muted. Okay.
Yeah. Right. David muted me, and I muted you.
Woo! TF2, everyone.
And I might mute David to win for us. I might kick him.
Where is this player? Where is Ryder? He's joined the.
Oh, he's on there now.
90
he
seconds
might have
from
got
this
lost
playoff.
On the way from the last map to this map. You know.
This is ridiculous. In this day and age, how these players cannot just jump into one game to the next. I just want to watch some TF2.
No, it's because in between them, they've got to walk their dog. You know, they've got to have dinner with their mum. All that stuff. Same
you
thing
joke,
with always
that's
some
actual,
TF2. Yeah,
that's the
probably
truth.
Is it. Yeah. It's like, oh, guys, we've just done the map. I remember it was Kyler. He always had to go for dinner with his parents every
Mom,
night.
Mum, just a minute!
But there was one point when we played a cup. I think it was like a Razor Cup. It might have been, I can't remember who it was with. I think it was with Suave, actually. We played, like, one cup, we won, and then he thought that we're going to take a break for 2 weeks. Like, no, we have officials, you idiot. It's just lazy people like that that stop TF2 from becoming an esport. And
yeah,
Mr. Sin and Sonny Black and Permzilla.
In a serious note, I'm gonna take this direction. Actually, no, this is the worst time to take this conversation in that direction, as the game is probably about to begin. I was about to ask you a very open-ended question, and you could have been rambling on for hours. I just saved you a lot of hassle.
Write that one down, and if there's ever a pause, I need 30 minutes of filler.
Yeah, we'll go for it.
Hit me.
Alright, okay. Well, countdown started. It felt like an eternity, but we are going into map number 2. Map number 1 was taken by the Animate Squad, which you do see in red, versus Stevie Wonder's AIM School in the blue. So it's going to be a mid-fight about to kick off. I am anticipating big plays from the Demoman of either side. Settler now trying to get in that early spam damage. A few pipes being sent away at Big Door. Currently, neither side want to take the initiative moving forward. In fact, the Rider's going to be finding that one kill onto Alfie. And there we go, the leap in as well by T-Mac. He's going to get brought down fairly quickly and easily by Phoenix. In fact, Leto has caught our position as well, so he's going to be falling. A mid-fight one to the side of Animate, pretty convincingly. However, the medics did survive, so they are going to have Uber to defend their second point with now.
They definitely can't defend it, though, because they don't have any soldiers, which is a disaster when you want to try and block this. Obviously, you can't close down that space on top. If you're a good player, Bren, you would know these things.
Yeah, I don't know.
So they just sort of fall back to last, and... oof, it's like we're watching Crowns.
Oh, don't do it. You're triggering me. Don't do it, War. Right now, Alfie finds the first kill onto T-Mac. That might be an entry they needed. T-Mac was on Sniper, seeing if he could wiggle his way around, picking up a frag or two along the way. Orton finds one as well, however. So, all is not lost for the squadron of men holding onto this second point. Animate still holding onto this Uber charge. And at this point, are they just going to wait for T-Mac? T-Mac has come back up. He is playing Soldier again, so no Sniper gimmicks just yet. But he has forced Martin into a bit of a odd position. I think they still think he might be running Sniper.
See, at the moment, I'd like them to sort of try and get some information to see if they can find where the Dareman is, where he's got stickies, because at the moment, the point's completely clear of them. So if you were to Uber
well,
two scouts
Orton on the back lines.
Oh, they read my mind thoughts.
There we are, but they've dropped two players as a result. It was a sacking attempt by Ryder, but he got cleaned up before he got absolutely anywhere. So, I mean, right now, Stevie's school, they could push in off this. They have 100%, they got the picks. Alfie has taken up this riverside area, but they're still holding strong for now.
Yep, they, hopefully, they actually sort of work on what they just did and realise that the point could be an exploit, as Yak is still not looking to sticky up the last point. And if they just commit two players, just Uber them through, Uber the scouts, there you go. You're going to get them on the point lots of time, because they're very, very, very poorly positioned on Stevie Wonder's AIM school.
They look like they kind of want to play off this. They're getting a few men in the riverside area, but they're just spamming.
Yeah, this is a... might be a note of inexperience, but...
Ryder looks like he wants to make a play happen. Here we go, he's leaping in. Gets one rocket, gets the second one! Martin with the force! And that is exactly what they were after. Now, Animate can look to try and take this any way they possibly can. They get forced out by Phoenix from behind. The big wraparound of 2016 as they're looking to make their mark.
Oh, he's got
the
pain train.
All the way in. Martin might be falling as well as Artin finds Alfie. Zen with the 2K. Yak and May going down. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy, goes the saying. And that's going to be one round to Animate.
Just put stickies on the point. That's all I have to do.
Yeah.
Because Settler had the pain train, so he was able to get so much time on that, and he's probably the best class that he'd won on it.
Well. Mid-fight number two. Settler taking a very aggressive approach. In fact, he's going to be finding some Yak. He's going to say, hello, Yak. Thank you for walking into my stickies. He's going to be happy with that frag, and immediately, the Stevie Wonder's AIM Comprehensive for Gifted Students is backing off to second. Now, they're going to be looking to wrap around here as Animate try and push forward a little bit. Get as many kills as they possibly can. In fact, Zen's going to be trying to take that 1v1 against Alfie, but he's having to back off on half half. Now the cap is starting to get popped off a little bit here. May is going to crater to Orton. T-Mac with the follow-up. A few rockets going his way. Might be enough to try and cap this off. In fact, they're going to be able to get it. Now they could catch a few players off guard here.
They should know that they were Riverside, so they can easily just sort of try and get in for free. I mean, there's now only three players anyway, so they should be able to get through main without Ubering. Oh, they've bitch popped.
Settler's dead anyway. The Yak with the pipe does bring him down. Uber charge going to be exchanged. It's going to be a slightly better one at that, coming out by the Stevie Wonder's AIM University and Ryder with the follow-up onto Phoenix. So, they're going to have to back off here. Understandable. Settler has just respawned, and it is not an Uber advantage going their way. So, I mean, they could look to replay this. In fact, Alfie is behind them currently, getting in a few rockets. In fact, Ryder's going to be falling. And he gets a second one onto Zen as well. Two picks. Could not have worked out more beautifully for them. As Stevie Wonder's squad look to move forward now, taking as much room as they possibly can. And they're going to be able to get the second point. Nicely done, lads.
I'm proud of you.
Yeah, they could have really milked that Uber going into last because there was really no pressure. Yak wouldn't have had enough time to put any stickies anywhere significant. But they just sort of give him too much respect. They just Uber through the door, so they have a lot less to work with. And obviously, they had more players. They have to multi a lot more as well. So it just seemed a bit of a poor management. Settler is crouching down in elbow. Oh, he's moved now. He had a sticky trap.
Zen on sniper. Just peeking around the corner. Is he going to get anyone? Yes, indeed he do. He is. Phoenix falls flat on his face. And with that one pick, they looking to play off it. The flank's looking a bit weak on the side of the Stevie squad. And they're going to be taking it all the way in. Uber's exchanged around the choke area. No casualties just yet. Alfie is very, very weak. In fact, Orton has wrapped his way around into the lobby area. He's found Yak in the end. And Leto's moving forward. He's found Fragmented. No medic for you. But Martin now might be the next one. Beautiful serve by him. There's a lovely attempt by Ryder. Unfortunately, not going to be paying off the dividends. T-Mac now in the back lines. Phoenix just about saves his life with the 2K as well. Top it off. That's just the cherry on top, really, isn't it? And now... Woo! Phoenix turning up. Settler goes down as well. That is some nutty gameplay.
That is, those were certainly a series of frags.
Thank you for that.
No problem. Back to you, Bren.
Well, now they're definitely going to be moving in off that. They do have a slight advantage of about 25%. Might be just enough to work off. We see Ryder, he's leaping in. He realizes this. Straight onto the back line of Martin. Eats one rocket. Can the spam finish him off? Now, his team are just not there to follow up on it. In fact, this is going to be the second point. Gonna go the way of the Stevie squad. Settler's trap strikes again as he finds out we have an ever unconventional one. Now, Stevie's AIM school. Moving on from that crushing defeat of losing their soldier, Alfie. Look to push forward with this Uber advantage, but it's an Uber advantage no longer as Fragmented does have it. Here we go, going to be popped off now. Start to try and play the point a little bit. Yak's getting a lot of cap time here, and they cannot let it go this way. In fact, he might be able to escape here in the underside. Zen going to be trying to chase him down now. This should be an easy kill. Indeed, it is. Two shots, all it takes, and a failed push by Stevie's squad.
Settler duped May so hard. May went in from lower to try and kill him. They just sort of completely duped him around the ramp, and obviously, beautiful. Yeah, just dead sticks as soon as he went on it. Ooh. He got trounced. It was a fantastic right click.
Love those sorts of plays. Alfie trying to get into one of those cheating spots. Valve, if you're watching this, please fix this, please. Mm. This is disgusting to see in a scene as prominent as ours.
TF2 major.
TF2 major event. That this remains unfixed, and frankly, I find it disgusting. So,
I've sent my email to Gavin already.
Good old Gavin.
I've just sent him the same email that I send to him every month.
What's that?
Hi. I get scared.
Yeah. Get anxious writing emails.
Yeah, I'm not so good talking to him. I don't know how to word it. Do I write yours sincerely or yours faithfully?
Hello.
Hello, Mr. Newell.
Mr. Newell. Getting a bit sweaty just thinking about it. There's a bit of a stalemate situation that we're seeing. Neither side wants to take the initiative, but I think off the back of those two picks that they just got, Settler finding Yak, Orton finding Leto, they should be very happy with this. In fact, they're going to be moving in off this now. In fact, they'd be mental not to. So, straight up, moving across the point, this is going to be the mid-capped at least, and no contestion just yet. The players have just respawned, so potential is there, but the big wraparound of 2016 is currently in effect. Settler trying to lead the charge of his team. The Ubercharge now going to get popped off. Ryder in the back lines. He's found a few rockets onto Yak. Yak just about surfs around, and he finds a kill onto Ryder anyway with one quick pip straight to the face, and Alfie has found T-Mac as well, so these are two quick kills going their way, which could turn it around. This could be the 180 they needed.
It very much looks like it, but I kind of felt like Anime could have really been a little bit quicker when they got those two soldier frags and pushed Big Door straight away and just let some people to cap. But it has turned on its head. They really need to thwart this Big Door aggression from Stevie Wonder's AIM school, but they're also losing their flank as well, so they should be giving this up, and it looks like they bloody well are.
Good heads up play there, War.
Thanks.
And by play, I mean good using your eyes.
Observation.
Good observational skills, but this is going to be the Uber charge. Moving in all the way, they realise they don't have it for a few seconds. Fragmented! Going to be going now nice and easily as positioning just was not there to escape from that. In fact, four kills now going down. It's all up to two members of the team, and they are dead. Zen on Pyro, the last bastion of hope. He's just spraying wildly into the air, just like I do on a Saturday night, and unfortunately not getting there with it.
That's icky.
Ah, that's a lie. I don't go anywhere on Saturdays.
Ew, gross. Do we have like a mature content filter on TFTV? I hope we do.
What we do after that one?
I hope my 10-year-old cousin Dominic doesn't watch this.
Mid fight number 3. I like to count out the mid fights. It helps me keep sane. Alfie's going to be the first one to go down. In fact, Ryder finds him nice and easily in that underside area. And immediately, look at this passive positioning. They don't want anything to do with it. They're going to be backing all the way off.
It's another convincing mid-fight win. They just really need to
seal the deal.
It looks like they're going to block it, and I do believe that this is brave.
That's very brave.
And they're out of position. Right, what they need to do now, they know where the medic is. Just go, that's it.
Go to last. Even I know this.
But they're in choke.
What's going on?
They backed out. They were like, nope, we see you there. Out of position in Riverside after we've just capped the point and hanging around there and possibly leaving your last point exploited. We're going to back out to choke.
Okay. Deep breaths. Animate are one round away for getting that coveted fifth placement spot in Prem. And Lord knows that they have worked hard to get here. Now, it is a revved up Hootis power on last. Phoenix running the heavy roll. Is he even running Natasha? I don't know if he is. He is, okay. He's not an amateur heavy enthusiast. He doesn't know what he's doing.
He's read the patch notes.
He knows what's up.
He's watched Mr. Slynn's latest video.
Oh my goodness. Two kills. Zenith. Otherwise known as Zen. The sort of chat was bullying me earlier for calling him Zenith.
Well, that is his name.
Yeah, well, that is the name that I'm reading currently off the screen.
Yeah, that's fine. Guys. You call him what you want. Like, I call Yak Sung, what looks like Blind Man
Sunglasses?
Yak.
Sunglasses?
It could be
Blind Man Yak.
Well, they are called Stevie Wonder's aim school.
I guess that makes sense, yeah. Alright, I'll give you that.
Thanks.
Rightio. T-Max found a kill onto Leto. Is this the opportunity they were looking for? No soldier onto last. They're not even taking lobby. They got a pick and they're just not even taking lobby.
Because it's just too dangerous.
What's happening?
And now Zenith is holding big door. This is awful. Ooh. If you look at their positions right now, David, I don't know if you can do this, but get a zoom out. This is atrocious.
Get a zoom out.
Look at this.
That's rule number one of observing.
You've got one team holding second with Fluba and one team holding last. The team holding second, what are they doing? They've got Uber.
I think they realise it's not. They're moving in now. They've finally taken up the lobby area. This is good.
I've got a nosebleed.
Right, you're excused. I'll let you go off. They're waiting for that one pick on Zen here. Zen on sniper, trying to skirt his way around. Phoenix is also on sniper. Seeing if he can get that shot. They do realise this. It's a heads up play by them.
This is.
He gets a body shot onto Yak. Yak is very weak. No follow-up. But right now, surely, you've got a bit of damage off. The medic is in an unfavourable position. He doesn't really want to be standing here, does he? You know, maybe now's the time to sack a few players in. I don't know.
Yeah, you kind of want to sort of actually do something when you're running a sniper. At the moment, it's let's sort of put ourselves into a compromising situation. Almost die to a player and repeat.
It does feel like they haven't. I don't know. I don't want to shit talk these guys too much because they are human beings with feelings.
And you're not really one to talk. You can't. Really
and I'm also not one to talk. I am terrible at the game. That's not an opinion. That's fact. So yeah.
I've got the I've got the ETF12 Premier Division winner medals multiple second place land finishes in Wonder Bomb Belt. To slap on the table in front of them and go, look, I'm more than qualified to say you're bad.
It's very slow paced. T-Max found Yak, that's a Demoman pick. Now that is a pick that you can play off.
That is.
And that is a pick that you want to play off. Phoenix has found Ryder. The Ubercharge going to be moving all the way in. Martin finally going to be popping off his as well. They're going to see which way they can potentially take this. Zen's found Alfie in the midst of all this chaos. And that could be a pick that can change the tide of this battle for the better. He finds another one onto May. T-Mac finds Martin. And there's the round. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Making quick work of the Stevie Wonder's AIM squadron of gamers. Now, 2-1 is the scoreline. Explanation on why it is so slow paced here.
Because these teams aren't very good at pushing.
Convinced. Alright, he's going to potentially kill Yak again, doing the exact same thing. Settler just leaped into him, got a few through stickies down. In fact, Yak is in a very sticky situation. He's nowhere on this mid fight. Two kills going away. Alfie and Leto. Martin might be the next casualty here. No, he just about leaps out, but goodness gracious me. Now Ryder gets the kill onto Yak! Orton with the follow-up,
they're
steamrolling. This is it. Surely this is another playoff. Orton's going all the way in. He's holding W. He wants blood. Phoenix brings him down. T-Mac now realizes, oh, I cannot run forward. I do not have my scout buddy. He's had the back off. But
Putain.
Ooh, that was looking good for a few seconds.
That was until they completely ballsed it up. And Settler's even, yeah, he's ballsed it up even more.
Hmm.
It's like, I don't like winning. Neither does Phoenix.
Feeding players into them. My god, they actually are. Uber did get popped off by Frag. That's going to be the only silver lining. Martin does have his Uber charge. Now he could get popped off here by Ryder. Ryder on the back lines! Did get the force out. That's what they wanted. And there we are. This is the play to make. Now if they just kite them out, take their picks well, take their fights well.
Oh, Settler.
Oh, Settler. Oh. Oh. That's dirty, my man. Oh, T-Mac with the 2K. Orton does find Orton, but this is looking dirty for anime right now. They're moving all the way in. They find another one. And now it's just Martin. One man against the world. Not enough to keep them off. 3-1 is the scoreline. We're just making Orton noises.
Man noises.
Man, I love football. Did you see that ludicrous display last night?
The thing with Arsenal is, right, they always want to walk it in. Blimey.
Ah, sports. Yeah.
Oh. Athletics and such.
Athletics. Anyway, mid-fight number 5. Alfie leaping in. See if he can get a kill. Zen's find May. So that's one pick that they could play off if they wanted to. Once again, T-Mac runs himself in. Gets one kill onto Leto. And now the counter jump in by Alfie. They are playing the point quite well, but I think Alfie, it's his time to die. Frag! Minted! The movement! What a god! Phoenix!
What?
Oh, oh, okay. Oh, how has he survived on such little HP? This man, he's part mermaid as well. I'm trying to make an analogy war.
Sorry.
Stop talking.
Sorry. Splash was a brilliant film. So you're too young to probably know that reference.
Yeah, I don't know what Splash is.
It's a film. It's with Tom Hanks and he finds a mermaid.
Well, Fragmented has been forced. Oh, that's a bit of a pussy pop. I don't think Alfie was going to hit that shot, but they did get the force off anyway. Fragmented. Going to have to move in off the Uber now. And we're going to see if they could do anything with it. They are moving forward with this player advantage. Orton already on last. Trying to spam them out. Phoenix has done a brilliant job of 1v1ing them at the cap time. Might be a little bit too much here. Fragmented falls. Ryder and Zed, the only two survivors. It's all up to Ryder. He cannot hit his shots. It's going to be a full wipe.
Ouch. I would tell you what happened, but I was too busy looking at Splash on IMDb.
Splash, yeah. When did it come out?
1984.
That was before I was born.
That was before I was born as well. That's how old that is. I was just looking at some of the trivia. Nothing amazing. Although Tom Hanks says that he was the 11th choice to play the main role in Splash.
11th choice?
I know. Although I guess he wasn't really... He didn't really have a huge break at that point.
Did he not?
I don't think so.
No, he definitely was. He was a very well-established actor by that point, I'm sure.
Let me just go back on the page.
Yeah, go back and have a look, please. Alright, forget the cast for a second.
No, you cast. I'll chip in off.
Yeah, okay. Alright, well right now... We'll see, Animate. They do have this massive lead. 10 minutes on the clock as it stands. It is trickling down. And it's really the Stevie squad in blue.
You know
that
what? He didn't have his big break then. Nope.
Really?
Yeah, that was one of his earlier films, that was. He started his career about 1980.
Are you sure? Guess,
yeah, I'm 100% sure.
I mean, Tom Hanks, he's getting on a bit now, isn't he?
I mean, 4 years later, he was in Big.
Big was a good film.
That is a very good film, yeah.
Anyway, I might watch it tonight. Thanks for sending that my way.
You should watch Zen's Splash, give a time of your analogy.
No. Zen's found two, in fact. He's found Yak as well. Two picks, two big plays by Zen. And there we go, the Uber's going to be coming in straight, hot and fast. Never exchange as well, as it's popped off both ways. But Fiend is going to be paying with his life. The Flash just could not make it to him. Now, Settler realises all he has to do is stick up the point, and this should be round number four going their way. And indeed it is. Played to an absolute T, all off the back of Zen. Zen's a gamer.
He's a good gamer as well. And he's a good mercenary to have if you ever want one. And he also has an animated spray.
You keep referencing this, but I haven't seen the spray in years.
I have sprays turned on. One of them's got an admirable spray, which I have as well. He's got an animated spray of Anna Kendrick. For the viewers at home that can't see it.
Interesting. Anyway, mid-fight number... What's this? Six? Yeah, six. Frag's died. Fragmented has fallen. But so has Martin. And this is an absolute cluster fudge. If I've ever seen it. Now it's all up to May to try and take this 2v2. Orton, or 2v1, I should say. Orton, very, very weak. Trying to take this fight. He just needs to bring him down. One scatter shot. The beep is real.
That's unfortunate.
The movement is real by Orton. As he did manage to evade him for a very, very long time while Zen was just picking away at him from behind. So that was a closer mid fight than what we're usually seeing. But again, not going the way of the Stevie boys.
Yeah, I have to say, Settler's doing a lot of work on mids. For the past few mids, he's really been sort of dominating position with his faster rollout. And, he's getting a bit too cheeky there, alone in choke, but his team
Alfie,
are now there to back him out.
He's moving in. Fragmented, falling a little bit weak. Phoenix with the follow-up onto T-Mac. And there we go. Phoenix wants to go for more. Woo-hoo! Frag says, not today. Finishes him up with a quick little arrow. So, mid-fight number one. Who's winning all these mid-fights? It is Anime, isn't it?
Just say a moment ago, if you were listening, I can't work with this.
You can't work with who? Me?
I can't work with someone who doesn't listen.
What were you saying? I wasn't listening to you.
To my analysis.
You're talking about... I was talking about analysis.
Settler's doing
really well
on mids, and he's been winning them.
Alright, well... Oh my god. Jesus Lord Almighty, man. What was that? And now the follow-up by Ryder
war trap.
From behind. It's the pincer strategy. We haven't seen this one since 2008. My goodness. Brilliant plays all around. They've just cleaned up.
Yeah, the pincer strategy was well known in the beta.
Beta of TF2. The pincer strategy. Used to see that one all the time on 2-4, but Ubers were exchanged by both these teams, just trying to force them out. It's pretty much a last-ditch effort. I can feel the teams tilting. I can feel it. I can feel Stevie Wonder's aim. Squadron of gamers just slowly slipping away into the mental abyss.
I think they've got a bit of... You know, they did just get around. Maybe they've got a little bit of momentum, you know? There's still time. There's still time for them to turn this around.
6 minutes, 20 seconds.
I need to remind you about TCM Bite.
You do it every time.
That's probably because you don't even know what I'm referring to.
Can I blame you? What's a Bite, by the way?
That is a video gamer.
8 bits, David whispers in my ears. Programming references! Programming jokes!
I don't understand that.
Okay. And there we are. Phoenix is going to escape with his life or not. He decides to take a 2v1 and dies. So, second point is going to get capped up here by the Animate boys. And Alfie finds Orton.
It looks like the dream is currently now withering away, as they do kind of need to push, you know? They got to push forward like TCM Byte did against TT Esports. That was in top 10 plays of the month.
How does it feel to be considered a dinosaur in TF2?
Scary.
Like, given the fact that in your eyes you probably think, I'm the new guy, right?
But in reality, you're not. Well, the scary thing is when you go to LAN and there's people that are like 4
4 years
and I'm like,
age.
Can I have your photo? I'm like, my restraining order says no.
Well, you say that, but Alfie and Leto have just gone absolutely ham. Fragmented has been made into mincemeat. And now Alton's trying as hard as to try and keep them off. The double soldier bomb was looking so good when they picked up Fragmented. It's just the dropping of players afterwards that wasn't looking so nice. And now I think the dream is well and truly withering away. Like a flower that's past its season.
Some would say it'd be wilting away like my erection.
No one would say that.
I would say that.
Right. You can cast for a bit. I'm done talking. I don't know if that was David that just said, please, a war, but...
Yeah, it was David. David, you broke it.
Oh, for Christ's sake. Anyway.
Something
TF2
happened.
TF2 is kicking off. Plays are being made. Oh, man.
Phoenix gets a 2K. What is he made out of? Certainly not pork. I think that's against their religion.
Whee! Hi-yo! Anyway, is Yak has gone huge with the 2K with the pipes. And they're going to be seeing if they can take this any further. Yak is leaping in. He's tired of his team not making the big plays. He wants to try and make them himself. The Uber's been popped off now. And now it's a 2v2 scenario. The Uber exchanged by both these teams and they're moving into the lobby area. Seeing what they can do now. If they can get any frags at all, this would be absolutely beautiful for them. But unfortunately for them, Zen is hot on Alfie's tail. And he does find that one kill. And with beautiful finesse and movement, he escapes. Oh, I spoke too soon as Maders find it.
There is just 3 minutes remaining, and Fragmented Prem Dream will be alive.
Woo!
Maybe.
All right.
It looks like it. I mean, these are just. I think it is now beyond their reach, needless to say. This is the moment where we all know that it's lost, but
yeah.
They do it for the logs.
You play for the airshots at the end of the day. And as we mentioned, airshots are all that matters in the road to becoming the best soldier in the world.
Mm. It is. Just ask Shadowburn.
Mm. Yeah. Nation Boy was Shadowburn the other day. Did you see that play?
Was it against me and my team?
It was, yeah.
Shut up. But you know, maybe if Nation is going to be Shadowburn, he will ask the community for money to buy a new computer and then disappear.
Yeah, why not? Well, he's making it big in Overwatch now, I believe.
Brilliant.
I think. Oh no, maybe he's not. I don't actually know.
He's in phase.
He's in phase. I thought phase disbanded.
They did, but then they restarted. Yeah, and they're probably going to disband.
How do you know more about Overwatch teams than I do?
I can't tell you that information. I'm their coach.
I think we discovered War's dirty little secret.
Yeah, I'm their coach.
Anyway.
Over.gg is my homepage. I don't even have Steam to start up with Windows anymore. It's Battle.net.
Woohoo! Alfie has switched to Spy, and that's when you know the nail is very safely placed in that coffin. And with that, Stevie Wonder's AIM school's dreams, their hopes and dreams, I should say, well and truly dusted. No prem for these guys.
There is some good things they can take from this.
Mm-hmm.
Martin, I think, performed very, very, very well.
Yeah.
He had some very, very good surfs. Certainly, held onto Ubers quite a bit, has a very good survivability. So, you know, he can sort of hold his head high above his team and call them terrible as you go look for a new team.
Yeah.
Yak as well performed pretty well, but I think overall they were just sort of missing a bit of stability that Animate had, especially on flanks. We saw on Badlands quite a bit. I think this was more just sort of like getting an out DM'd kind of scenario. On Badlands it was certainly a case of being outplayed on the flank because they had such a good push onto last. Well, they had such a good percentage of control. Well, there is only 7 seconds left. They had such a good percentage of control across the whole map. I'm trying to analyse.
I'll let you do that.
They just got pooped on by backups and stuff. And that's a summary.
We got our logs. Logs are here. They are in our presence. Anything that points out to you, my good man, wore her yet?
I have white screen.
Ah, white screen syndrome. An absolute classic.
Oh, I can see it now. Zenith having huge amount of frags. I do have to question whether or not that was a good merc to allow. Because if I'm honest, he was quite influential on this map, and dare I say, quite a bit in the last map as well. So I would say that was a mistake. But
yeah,
the logs speak for themselves. The majority of players doing the most well, pretty much all the players are top fraggers on Animate.
Yep.
Riders up there with Phoenix as well. So overall, it tells the tale. Airshot victory, Alfie wins. So, you know, that's a good thing as well. But they did well.
Yeah.
But ultimately, I guess it's just when you look at the lineup of Animate and you also allow them to have Zen as a merc, you know, it's going to be a tough time for your players. But they almost beat us yesterday on Gullywash.
Yeah.
So they have obviously reason to believe that they should certainly do well in high.
Okay, well, we're trying to figure out if interviews are going to kick off. Somehow I doubt they are. I don't know. So I think after that game, all I'd want is a nice cup of tea and a rest.
But, yeah.
Who knows?
Hint, hint, David.
Hint, hint, David.
Yeah,
hint.
All we'd like is to just, you know, get ourselves tucked into bed.
You know, it's 9:30. I got school tomorrow.
Yeah.
Don't do me any favours.
Yeah, I've got to go to sleep.
Start my first history class tomorrow.
No way. Who's your teacher?
Right. Right here.
Sort of that ruse, didn't I?
We're going to wrap it up. We're going to wrap it up. This is the wrap-up beginning right now. I've heard in my ear, you may wrap it up. You may go to bed. So, a big thank
Thanks,
you.
Thanks, David!
A big thank you to not only David for letting us not do an interview, but and also a big thank you to you guys watching at home, all 515 of you. You know, if you do enjoy TF2, whatever, visit Team Fortress TV. Could always do with some more traffic if you are interested in the competitive side of it. That is the competitive side of it, not the competitive. You know, hover over there. Go over to Team Fortress TV, tf.gg, I think you can also go to. I don't know why you would. But also, Tip of the Hats is on, isn't it? Tip of the Hats is taking place very soon. So, yeah, you guys can watch that. There's a big charity event. I think the general gist of it is it's some nutty stuff. If we go to Tip of the Hats, Tip of the Hats, I think it's .org? Mm. Yeah, it is. You go to that. It's a nice little charity event. I'm just going to read off this page now because it deserves a little bit of a say. I imagine if you're watching this now, you do know what Tip of the Hats is. But then again, there could be some new viewers. You found us from the streamer list. You don't know. So Tip of the Hats is a charity event hosted and supported by members of the Team Fortress 2 community. Since 2013, it has raised over $320,000 for the Children's Oncology Services Incorporated, which offers camps and other educational incursion programs throughout a year that allows children with cancer to just be kids. So it's a very nice little thing that they do. You know, they do it every year. You get all the TF2 personalities there. You know, we're sending over a few EUs this year. We got Sideshow and Ads, haven't they, from EU going over just to mess around a little bit. But yeah, I think this is safe to say, you know, go check that out. That's going to be this weekend, 16th, 17th and 18th of September. War, any final moments you want to say? Anything you want to add?
Anything I will say will merely just put a Debbie Downer on that fantastic outro, Brendoline. So I'm going to continue with that and say, don't forget to subscribe to twitch.tv/warhere/subscribe.
Of course. Yeah. Who could have forgotten the war plug? all right. We'll call it a night.
T-shirts coming soon.
Yeah. I think that was the last game to be played in ETF2L until the new season's on. But But, you know, if you're an American, there's some ESEA coming up in about 6 hours' time, unless they've moved that game as well. So you can catch that as well. There's also, you know, Oz Fortress and things. But with that being said, thank you very much for watching, and good night.